I have with me Mr. Madhukar Tripathi of Nirvitsu. Thank you so much, Mr. Tripathi, for joining us. Well, it's a great show we have here. If you could tell us your involvement in this show. Is this your first year?
No, we are participating in Convergence for the second time, but after a gap of 2 years. So this is one of the great show in India, which is happening for the ICT, Information, Communication and Telecom industry. And the all segments of telecom, all domain of telecom is here. It is good to be here, and like it's more for branding and awareness about our product to the customer and meeting our existing customers.
Well, we are fourth in the world in terms of telecommunication. Do you really think this is a grand time for India?
Yeah, see, definitely India is the second largest market for the smartphone and the fourth in the world in the terms of subscriber base. And everybody from the globe, they are seeing India as an opportunity country where they can invest a lot in the terms of, you know, human resources or the development or the selling, marketing activities. So India is definitely a great market for telecom in general.
Well, if you could tell us about the products you have here. Are you catering just to India, or are you also going ahead and exporting your products outside of India?
We are displaying here a wide variety of instruments. We have classified them as RF and microwave and optical test instruments, which are being displayed here. And we also have the mobile handset testing, which is a great market for India. And the instruments can be classified as the field testing instruments. They are battery operated, handheld, and also the latest technology touch screen. And we are also displaying some high grade R&D products, which are used in the research and development from the defense organization or the telecom industry or even the production companies from the different telecom domain. This is what we are displaying here.
So are you dealing just business to business, or is it also the consumers? Do you also have B2C involvement?
Our customers are mainly on the telecom domain or telecom segments. So all the mobile operators, all the network installation companies, or their subcontractors who work the installation, site installation or the laying the fiber, they are our client. And the people who are working on the mobile handset development or production, they are also a customer for us.
Right, so I believe it's not a good news for you because the national fiber optic plan has been delayed. It's running late. So what's your take on it?
Yes, see, for the end user or for the general public, it is not a good sign because they will be, you know, getting the good services or the high quality speed of internet and other things in a later part. But sooner it happens, it's better for everyone, even the general public, even for telecom industry or the stakeholders like us.
Let's talk a little about the political happening here. We saw the change of government last year and we have Delhi elections. So what's your expectation from the government here in Delhi and also in the center?
See, this is a very good question. What we see with the new government, people are now more hopeful on the government pursuance motive of the Digital India or Make in India. And we really see this will boost our GDP also, and this is giving a confidence to the telecom industry that future we will, after a silence of 4 to 5 years, we will further improve in the terms of quality of instruments or the instruments or the investment in the telecom or the new production facilities, everything. So this is a positive signature for everyone.
A question here with regards to your products. Do you have customized products? Because the Indian market is a completely different market. We have people with high purchasing power and we have people looking for just for a product between 5,000 to 10,000. So have you categorized your products?
See, yeah, as I said, we have the products which are handheld. They are, of course, the cheaper version, or they are very cost effective. Actually, the only reason for any company to exist in India, they should be always a cost effective. And India is a very cost sensitive country. So we do have, we do have a cost effective performance instruments, and we do have everything for every budget, you can say. So we start the products from $5,000 and it goes up to 1 million, 2 million kind of thing. We have everything for every budget. It depends on what people want, what is the application, and we offer this suitable solution based on their requirement and budget.
A little about Convergence India event we have here. This is known as one of the biggest international event here. Will soon become 25 years. So what's the takeaway for people from this event, Convergence India event?
Yeah, Convergence India is a great show. I have been a visitor to this show for last 10 years almost. And we are also participating as a company. we see all variety or domain of telecom, ICT, information communication technology domain here coming. And this is a good gathering and knowledge sharing platform where we know about new things, what's happening in the market, and also the marketing point of view, we are putting ourselves as a branding platform. Yeah.
Last question, I have to ask you this question because you've been from the telecom sector. What's your take on the public-private partnership with regards to the telecom sector and also your company? What is your initiative acting as an enabler to Digital India?
See, PP model is very good. I mean, this will definitely help to the end user or the customers or general public also. And also, it will improve the image of government also, that they are doing something for the public. And from the industry, this is a good sign that they are also involved in the telecom-related things or the industry-related things. This is really good for everyone.
Anything else you would like to add?
Yeah, Anusu is one of the leader company in the test and measurement. And we have very unique products. Our products are known for this high standard quality and reliability. And we are proud to be a vendor or partner to the Indian telecom industry. We have sold thousands of OTDRs when the optical revolution happened in India, like 20 years back. So that is the legacy we carry in India from the test and measurement point of view. And today we are catering all the LTE related technology, everything new. So we are bringing new things to the Indian market.